Hi everybody, it's RPG Grandma again, and I'm doing the next episode on Arduin. You know, the art on here, I mean, that's one cool elf. Little insect dude, I mean, come on. Something to be said for art like that. I know the new made on the computer stuff's cool too, but I don't know. I like handheld, hand drawn. I like books I can hold. All right, so we were working on creating characters, and I had said that maybe I should talk a little bit about character races. So let's talk about elves. They're an ancient race. They're tall and slender. They have them about 5'8" to 6'5", weighing between 105 to 200 pounds. Usually light complexions, fair hair, very light brown to silvery blonde. They say they never have red hair, and they usually have green, violet, lavender, purple, or pearlescent gray eyes. There are three basic types of elves in this game. The very tall and very rare high elves, usually dwelling in the frosty mountain splendor. The more numerous sylvan or wood elves that make their homes in the deep forests. And finally, there are the shortest kind called sea elves, usually living in underwater caverns and as at home in the water as a dolphin. Both the high and sea elves are seldom seen by anyone, almost never having dealings with mankind. The most common player type is the wood elf, a doughty fighter and a merry and good companion to all they decide to adventure with. All elves love music. They're fine singers. Most play an instrument, usually a lyre, mandolin, harp, or flute, but do so only among themselves for their close friends, as they feel that their music is something very personal. So, even though they're musically inclined, they might not make the best bard. Let's see. Oh, they can live 10,000 years. Elves have all the time in the world to learn what they want, but tend to be either mages or warriors, and sometimes both. See, high elves favor broadswords and beautifully worked armor, usually scale or chain, and as often are not mounted, much like knights. Wood elves seldom wear armor, preferring green, brown, and other woodsy colored clothing, are wont to use wonderfully carved long bows, spears, and daggers. Although they prefer to hit and run tactics, firing their arrows from cover, they are not afraid to commit themselves to hand-to-hand combat. Sea elves wear very little clothing beyond colorful loincloths and use long and cruelly barbed tridents, curved daggers, and throw weighted nets to ensnare their enemies. All elves have pointed ears to a greater or lesser extent. So high elves have the most pointed, and I guess wood elves the least. And their ears are set slightly, eyes are set slightly slantwise to their heads, lending them to have almond eyes. Look. They are happy but not frivolous, and studious when necessary, but not serious by nature. They never lie and will always repay a debt, even if it takes 1,000 years. So that's a little background on what elves are like. No weapons restriction mentioned because of their race. Mainly, look, if you come from this culture, you're most likely to use these weapons. And it makes sort of sense. All right, dwarves, a race nearly as old and as magical as the elves. These short, muscular people ranging in height from 3.5 feet to 5 feet tall, and from 100 to 190 pounds, usually have dark complexions and hair, brown, black, or even rust red, with most males having long beards. There are two basic types of dwarves, the mountain or dark dwarves, and the taller stone dwarves, or stone downers, or common dwarves. Okay. They both are feisty and touchy, tending to fight first and ask questions later. They are very long-lived, 500 or more years, and ponder things for a time before acting, never acting until they are ready. They like to drink and tell tall tales. They think that elves are snooty, humans too unpredictable, hobbits too frivolous, and detest all orc kind with a passion even more so than the elves do. So I guess elves don't like orcs either. Although most dwarves are decent beings, some are easily corrupted and turned to evil, having no redeeming traits whatsoever. Dark dwarves favor battle axes, and stone downers favor great hammers, usually swung two-handed. Both wear much armor, chainmail, or plate, and are stubborn and persistent hand-to-hand fighters. Dwarves are warriors as well as craftsmen, and seldom, if ever, dabble in things magical. They do occasionally work with elven craftsmen, to produce magical artifacts and weapons. They love gold and precious things avidly, and each dwarf has a 20% chance of simply grabbing any valuable without thinking. They're little thieves. Finally, dwarves are extremely loyal to those they consider friends and never forget their enemies. Don't put a shiny thing in front of a dwarf is what they're saying. Might shove it in his pocket. Hobbits. They are happy, sometimes frivolous race, which love parties and eating, preferably cakes, cookies, and other kinds of baked goods. For the record, my coworkers are hobbits at heart. We are hobbits down there. Ranging in size from 3 feet to 3 feet 10 inches and from 40 to 85 pounds. They are noted for their ability with slings and their dislike of water. They do bathe. They just won't swim in the horrid stuff. So not good at swimming, I would imagine. With a lifespan roughly the same as humans, their close resemblance, save in height, they are sometimes referred to as half-men or halfers. They tend to be thieves if they leave their own hometown or go adventuring, preferring to live by their wits and not be hampered with all sorts of equipment or armor. They wield slings, daggers, and an occasional short sword, preferring to shoot from hiding rather than standing up and slugging it out. Do not misunderstand, however, they are inordinately brave and capable of the greatest acts of loyalty and heroism. They usually come in one of three types: the taller, darker gravelers, who are usually associated with stone downer settlements; the more common plowfoots, usually found in small farm-oriented villages; And lastly, the small, secretive, streetwise, or city hobbits. Most hobbits love to smoke tobacco in long, slender clay pipes and to pester people with riddles. The most convoluted, the better. The more convoluted, the better. Hobbits get along well with most races, but hold elves in awe. Mayfair Games put out Rolaids, and they renamed their hobbits, just for the record, Shirelings, which I kind of like as a term, just as a role-playing game term. And then you can use like halfers and halfling and halfmen, as the human insult is probably meant to be towards them. And, you know, hob means small, but then you got the hobgoblins, so it's a weird thing. So, oh no, I just like Shirelings because they're from the Shire. Makes sense. I think that was a good call for the folks who came up with that from Rolaids. But yes, they have actual hobbits in Ardoon. Amazons. Amazons are female warrior race that live in a culture run by and for females. They are tall, 5'8" to 6'5", and athletic race, weighing 130 to 175 pounds. They live as long as humans. They have slightly bronze to golden tan skin coloring and favor long, single braided hair, usually light brown to dark honey blonde. Their eyes are usually shades of gray or blue, but amber eyes are occasionally found. There are three distinct types of Amazon. The most numerous are the seagoing gypsy corsairs, who use light leather armor and cutlass as well as short bows. The least numerous are the very dark, complexioned, and tall jungle living kind, who fight with no armor and use light javelins, short spears, and long double-edged curved knives. The third kind is by far the most often seen on adventures, coming from the loose coalition of city-states known as the Motherland. They wear armor, not unlike the classical Greeks did on Earth, using long spears, tall shields, and carrying large leaf-bladed swords. All of them have a terrific joy of life and do not hate men. They simply believe that they are better than men on the whole, so of course women should run things. They are fairly clannish, but will not hesitate to try to get to know a male that interests them. They are ferocious fighters, and clans have been known to carry on blood feuds for centuries. There have been so few Amazons that have ever done anything except become warriors that the name of those who become something else are spoken of for centuries as legends. Not very good legends either, because the culture stresses the warrior ethic. They do not practice self-mutilation, as some legends have it, believing in the axiom, whole body, whole mind. All right. Half-orcs. Half-orcs are the offspring and matings between humans and orcs. They are universally disliked by practically everyone and looked upon with suspicion. They are hardy and muscular lot, ranging in size from 5'6" to 6'3" tall, weighing 150 to 195 pounds. With yellow, amber, orange, or dull red eyes, their hair is coarse and shaggy, usually a blackish brown in color. They have faintly yellowish green tinge to the rough skin. Their teeth are gray-green, and the two canines are extraordinarily long and pointed, as are their ears. They will use any kind of armor or weapons, but prefer studded or banded leather armor, and scimitar-like swords. Those that are missile weapons prefer light crossbows. They are almost always warriors or thieves, although some take to the more evil gods and become priests as followers of priests, or followers of priests. Because they are so disliked, they tend to mistrust everyone. They live about as long as dwarves and dislike elves greatly. Humans. Humans are at once both the very best and the very worst of everything. They can be of any class and any alignment and vary in looks and equipment just as we do on our world. They are neither more nor less than what we ourselves are. Humans have the widest range of possibilities, but no special attributes save adaptability. In a fantasy world, humans live 100 to 120 years, getting old only in their 80s, and staying very active until then. Okay, so that is a bit on the basic races. There are so many others. So many. And some of them are so cool. Like, want to play a centaur? You can. Want to play a cobbit? That's a kobold hobbit mix. And much more. Early D&D, like if you look in Dragon magazine articles, like you'll sometimes find like these weird races. You go read what they are, you know, then they'll just be in a, like a graph or, you know, like a, you know, role for racial type or whatever. It's from somebody's home game. Much more diversity. Even Mayfair Rolades back here. Much more diversity in what was going on. So if you're playing 5e and you think it's rocking with the races it's got now. No. No, it's got nothing. Nothing compared to what some folks were doing. So we'll eventually get to those other races, but for the purpose of let's learn to play, those are the races to think about. I already went over the mechanics of making the character. So now you know what the race choices are and have a better idea how they present culturally. And fit in with those mechanics. So think about, remember, because you got to choose your race first. Think about what race. Then go ahead and roll up a character if you're following along. We'll get to money. We'll get to things like creature, character, and monster vision. We'll get to all that stuff. We'll get to classes. So you can pick out your class. And then I'll come up with something that on your end, you can play along. I'll figure out how to do that. But you can learn the mechanics. And then we'll really start delving into why Ardum is cool. It's so cool. So cool. Anyway, like, subscribe, comment. Have a great day. Bye, everybody. Ardum. It's nifty.